Nothing here to fear. I'm just sitting around being foolish when there is work to be done. Just a hang-up call and the quiet
Hi guys! So it's dark out and I'm using my lamp instead for light because I don't have natural light. I just got back from the screening of The Ghosts in Our Machine, and I wanted to do a review now since it's fresh in my mind and I literally just got home. My friend Samantha that was there mentioned to me that I should do a video review of, and I thought it was a pretty good idea. I mean, to start off, I thought the movie was fantastic. It was just beautifully done. Basically, there's not a lot of violence in it, so anybody that's kind of scared to see it, don't be scared, because I was nervous too, but it's not bad. It's not like Earthlings or anything. Basically, the story follows this photographer. Her name is Joanne MacArthur, and she basically goes into scary places like fur farms and slaughterhouses and stuff like that, and photographs the animals in these situations. I don't know how she does it, because I was crying, and I'm not even really living that situation, so I can't even imagine what it's like to be there and see these animals face to face, because I don't think I could sit by. It's so hard. She talks about how leaving them behind is the hardest thing, and I can't even imagine. I always feel like I just want to crawl through the screen and save them somehow, and I know I can't, and it's a really hopeless feeling, so I can't even imagine. But the thing that is beautiful about the film is it shows, you know, these photographs that she's taken and the places that she's gone into, like the fur farms. And then it goes to Farm Sanctuary, where she gets to spend, you know, these time with happy animals, and it's just really beautiful, and to see her passion for these animals, it's touching and it's beautiful. And I really think the movie is really good because it's not gonna scare people, it's not gonna, you know, traumatize people, and I think that's important. I think that, yes, slaughter videos do work for some people, obviously, who really wants to sit and watch a slaughter video, but I think for some people, sometimes more gentle things can do the trick, so I think this movie's really important for that reason. My only complaint, and I actually questioned, there was a Q&A with Liz Marshall, the producer, director, whatever you want to call it, and I actually questioned why the egg industry wasn't included in the film. That was the only thing that I kind of was a little bit surprised there was no egg industry. So that's my only little complaint, was that there was no footage of that, and I do think that's an important thing to cover. It covered a lot of things. It covered like fur farms, animal testing, of course meat, so they had like a scene with cows and a scene with pigs. So I was surprised there was no chicken scene. My only real complaint was that. Other than that, it was a beautiful film. And I really recommend it to people. The only other complaint that I had about tonight, which it's not really the film's fault, is just that the event was kind of like sponsored or brought in by WSPA or WISPA, and they're like this welfare organization. They had stickers, like actually they gave me a bag after it, and like you can get it, you know, right from that, but you know, it includes like a sticker that says choose cage free, which is like, fuck no, that's retarded. And I don't understand why they would really bring in a movie that's basically promoting veganism. It just doesn't really make sense to me, but anyways, kind of beside the point. I just was my little rant about that. So yeah, that's my review. I know it's not long, but it's kind of all I need to say. It's a really great film, and I really recommend it. So yeah, that's it. I'll talk to you all again soon. Bye, guys.